Hello, Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, with my continuing my Q&A, and tonight I'm talking to
pretty straightforward movie type questions.
What are some of your films? So I would assume he's talking about DVDs and things like that,
because we get into favorite movie experiences after this.
Well, that's a good question. I don't have a big collection of DVDs. I had a much bigger collection of VHS, and then when I moved back to be semi-retired after a lengthy career, moved back to my home province of Nova Scotia from British Columbia, I gave away my my VHSs, just about every one of them, and Ted did most of the collecting of the DVDs, but you know, I've purchased some, but I just want to show you a few that are favorites of mine. I don't buy slice and dice, scatter gore, torture porn. These are not my thing. Okay. Now, you see, to me, this is a good movie, and a lot of people wouldn't like that because I like Andrew Lloyd Webber. I like Broadway musicals. So I thought, I went to the show to see this movie. I think it was digital presentation. Oh, it's hard to get away from the glare. And I thought this was fucking fantastic. And I've always liked the music, but I loved, considering it's Joel Shoemaker, and I don't like a lot of his work, I thought that he did a fantastic job, and whoever did the art design and all of that, I loved the opening where they have the old dusty theater that had been closed for years in Paris, and all of a sudden it's going back in, with memory and then back in time, and the whole thing to me was extremely exciting when this wash of color went up the theater and took away all the dust and all the debris and all these bright red chairs, you know, that people would be sitting in seats. I thought that was a fantastic start, you know, for a cinema presentation of a Broadway and London West End musical. So I like this movie. The other things that I want to show you, a couple of my favorites are actually television things. I mean, I have Lord of the Rings. I have those three movies and that. And, you know, and I'll get to that. Like, this is my favorite science fiction show. Can you see that? Babylon 5. And I'm a big Star Trek fan, as everybody knows. But I love this. And I haven't opened my box set, but I've seen them so often. This is just a, you know, it doesn't really matter. And then, this is how far back I go. That's the future, Babylon 5. Phantom of the Opera was the present, basically. And this here, the Foresight Saga, this is the original series that I first saw in 1967 or 1969, a BBC series, the last major series that they did in black and white. So you have to be, as I've said many times, you're not going to see this unless you saw it on television the first time. It's not going to cross your mind to watch it. And search out the video. Okay? So I have seen this completely probably three times now, probably twice on television and once watching every one of these 26 hours. The Foresight Saga. This is the last major serial that the BBC did in black and white. Everything after that was in color. And the modern audiences find it incredibly boring because it moves so slowly, but that was television drama from England in 1960s. I think they started filming it in 66, and we might have had it in Canada or something in 68 or 69, something like that. And I have all the books. If you look at my creaky shelf here, the one that's bent, those books with the similar spines in the left-hand corner are the books that this was based on. So I love that. And then I love things like... I'll get to the next question. It'll make more sense. So anyway, we have probably 100 or so movies. We don't have 1,600, and we don't have 500 movies upstairs. But we've got a, you know, we've got a pretty good collection.
you know, so we'll get to that at some point in the future. I'll go through everything. And I'm still astonished and embarrassed to say that we've never opened Saving Private Ryan. It's still in its original plastic DVD from its first printing, I think. And we've never opened The Aviator. And I was dying to see that movie, the one with DiCaprio. You know, because I've read quite a bit about Howard Hughes. And isn't that crazy, what you end up doing to yourself? Okay. Item number two was, what are some of your favorite movie theater experiences? And I think that's another way of probably saying, what are some of your favorite movies? But I've got to tell you, as far as a physical experience and gimmick experience, in 1974, I think it was, Earthquake came out. Earthquake and The Towering Inferno came out, I believe, the same year. And I wasn't crazy about Earthquake, but at that point, the major theaters had put equipment in their theaters. It was called Sensoround, I believe. And, you know, subsidized by the studios, I guess. So that whenever the big earthquake in that movie hit, you had a big rumble and your seat vibrated, basically. So that was really, I mean, that was actually laugh-inducing, but at the same time fun, you know. And I, as many of you know, I'm blind in my right eye, so I've never seen 3D in real life, let alone at the movies. So I can't have any 3D experiences. And IMAX, I've only been to one IMAX presentation, and that was at Expo 86. And it hurt my head so much, and I couldn't see anything in 3D, that I've never gone to an IMAX, because it just isn't worth it for me to see that big screen. I can't focus on the whole screen. So that's a bit of both that. To me, masterful movie theater or movie experiences are things like seeing my first second Star Trek movie, because you do not know how much of a Star Trek fan I was, and to finally get it to the screen, I mean, I couldn't believe it. I was like what's the expression? Happy as a dog in shit, you know, or pig in shit. I was so happy. Every 2 years of James Bond, I love the experience of the expectation of a James Bond movie. I really enjoy that. Star Wars, never been a real big fan of Star Wars. I mean, I like it, but it's not something that I'm drawn to, like a lot of you, because it's a childhood experience as well for a lot of you, and it isn't for me. I was an adult. I mean, mind you, 25, but still an adult when it came out. I like experiences like going to see the movie Resurrection in 1982 with Ellen Burstyn, and I love that movie so much. Ted and I went to that, and we both loved it so much, and most people have never seen it, that I had an incredible emotional reaction to that movie, Resurrection. Out of Africa knocked me out completely. Sweet Dreams, I was terribly emotionally involved with that. That's the Patsy Cline movie starring Jessica Lange. And the when I saw the double whammy of Kate Winslet a couple of years ago in Revolutionary Road and The Reader, I went to the movies to see those. I very seldom actually go to the movies anymore. And I love those. I thought I like that mature story experience. I like my movies to be like novels quite often. So I guess I tend to a lot of more mature movies. And what else? You know, there's always something, but you can't think of it, you know? You can't think of what the questions and what the answers to the questions are all the time. So I'm not sure what else to say. What got you inspired to make YouTube videos, and what do you think of the experience so far in YouTube? Basically, I've been thinking about webcamming and that sort of thing for quite a while, and then when I unexpectedly lost my job, I hadn't worked in a long, long time, like a couple of years, you know, 2 or 3 years, and then I needed some work. And I got a job that I thought was full-time, and then I was let go at 4 months in last year, you know, for various reasons. I mean, I wasn't incompetent, but, you know, there were obviously issues with the management of the department, and the way she saw the way I was somehow interacting with her or whatever, that I wasn't jumping as high as she wanted or something, I'm not quite sure, but it was a bad experience. And I was very, very low. I was very, very low indeed. You know, depressed basically, but trying not to get too depressed because I had been depressed a few years ago. And that's why I wanted to leave work full-time and move back home. Anyway, so I went on YouTube, and if you, you can't see my first videos because they're all not available right now because I had changed channels and things, but I was pretty morose. And so I wanted to go in and just get to know some people, and I thought I might have something to say. And I know that I talk a lot and can get kind of lost sometimes with my point in that, but I think what I've got to say, for the most part, I think is worth listening to. I mean, if you don't feel that way, you've got no business broadcasting yourself to the world, in theory. And that's what happened to me, and so far I've been very, very happy. I've gotten much more relaxed. I've refused to do a bunch of jump cuts and speed myself up too much. I'm not a trained monkey, a trained seal, and I'm not going to jump and run around and scream and make funny noises. That's not my thing. So, you know, you're either going to go along for the story or you're not. And I don't have a lot to sell you, so, you know, suit yourself, basically. I mean, I want as many viewers as I can get, obviously, but, you know, I'm not going to change to a great degree. And I am, I've been very, very happy with my experience. I mean, there's haters out there that can get you down for a couple of hours, and then you move on, you know. But there's a lot of discrimination in the world, and it does, and it certainly is very, very prevalent on YouTube. Just say something controversial. Just say something anti-religious. Say something pro-choice, and they'll find you. The people who hate gay people lurk and pull up anything that's got gay in it just so that they can say something hateful. And that hurts, you know, but we know that, but that sort of thing. So aside from those idiots, it's been a good experience. I've really enjoyed getting to know people. I like to webcam. I mean, meaning I want to do more. What's that thing? The Skype. But I haven't gotten too many IDs from people, so basically I've only had 2 Skype calls, one with friends in Vancouver and one with a new friend in Australia. So it's not. But I'm open to that if people would like to, you know, make some appointments and we could call each other every once in a while and just shoot the shit for a while. Anyway, those are the questions from Justin, Ryan1988, who just did over 600 videos, and I salute him for that. Probably has more subscribers than me, probably hundreds more. And I really appreciate those questions. I think it's very sweet that he took the time, or that you took the time, Justin, to ask me those questions, because I know you're very, very passionate about movies, and you know, you love to share your passion about it, so I appreciate that. So I hope this has been moderately informative and entertaining for everybody, and stay tuned over the next week, and I'll probably get to all the questions, because I don't have any shifts at the ticket agency this week. I just came off 3 long days today, that's why I haven't been on as much. Okay? Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, and I'll see you soon, and don't eat anything bigger than your head, and don't eat any Skittles that are too big to swallow. Bye-bye.